Want to see how you can build this interactive dashboard from scratch in just 5 minutes? Take the principles that you learn here to rapidly create your own interactive web applications and dashboards with your own visualizations. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. This video is a preview from my new course, R Shiny Flex Dashboards and Interactive Data Visualizations, which has over 30 lectures and downloadable code that you can use for your own projects. You can check out a free sample course, which already has over 2 hours of great content from my website, www.datastrategywithjonathan.com. So I'm going to start off by setting up a new Flex dashboard. I'm going to come over to New, R Markdown, from Template, and I'm going to select Flex Dashboards, which is something I've installed earlier. Over here, I'm going to type in Demo. Let's just collapse this a bit. This section up the top here is basically where we can configure all the layout options of our dashboard. I'm just going to use all the defaults so I can actually get rid of these to make it a little bit more simple. But there is another section, of course, which goes over all of these options in detail. Over here, I'm going to say I want to make this an interactive Shiny application. So here I'm going to have to say runtime Shiny. I'm going to use a couple of libraries for this example. The first one being iGraph. And the second one is VizNetwork. This first column here, I want to set this up as a sidebar to contain a couple of input fields. And this section over here, let me just get rid of this column width because that'll be too skinny. Over here, I'm going to put our graph visualization. Let's just call that graph viz. Let's make this a little bigger so we can see everything on one screen. Get rid of that because I only have one visualization. So from here, I can do something pretty simply. I'll need to render a visualization. So I'm going to want to render viz network. I have to put some curly brackets in here. Make tree. And you can see here, I've got a couple options. I've got n for the number of nodes, and let me pop that up again, and the number of children that each node has. So let me just set some numbers in here to start with, 10 and say 2. And I'm going to pipe this into viz_igraph. So if I just run that quickly, I can see I get something that looks a bit like this. Let's just adjust a couple of these settings here. So I'm going to say layout as tree and circular equals true. There we go. So let's just collapse that for now. And add a couple of inputs. So let's swap these two numbers out here for a numeric input. We'll call this n, that's the ID for identifying it. Let's call this number of nodes, and we'll set a default value equal to 10. And over here, we'll have a slider input. We'll call this children. And over here, we'll have a label number of children. So here, we're going to have the min value, max value, and default value. So I'll say 1, maximum 10, and we'll have a default value of 2. So down here, to use these input fields, I can just type in input dollar n and input dollar children. Let's just drop this down to give us a little bit more space. And now we can run this and check it out. So I'm just going to call this demo. And there we go. Our first application in less than 5 minutes. So I hope you enjoyed this quick demo. As we go through this course, I'm going to show you how to build this out in more detail, as well as show you best practices, such as splitting your data manipulation and visualization code to keep things clean, flexible, and more reusable. So ultimately, we can spend less time writing code to get more results. I hope you're really excited, and I'll see you in the next lecture.